Dear professional colleagues, in this video, I am going to discuss three topics, interesting topics. In this COVID situation, physical board meeting cannot be held, so only video conferencing meetings are being held. In such a situation, if financial statements are not signed by the directors, what will be the status, whether it is legally valid? The question is, in case of board meeting held through video conferencing for approval of financial statements, can the directors sign the financial statements on the same board meeting date, or physical copies should be there for signing the same? So this question was raised to ICICI, and ICICI has answered that the directors are not in a position to physically sign the financial statements or minutes or any other documents, or scan and send, while approving the financial statements through video conferencing or OAVM. The directors may give an affirmation that they are approving the statements, reports, and considering the lockdown situation, they cannot sign the statements physically as of now, and they shall be deemed to be signed as on date of the board meeting, and they shall physically sign the financial statements, minutes, or any other documents as soon as the normalcy is restored as on the date of meeting. Such affirmation shall also be included in the minutes of the meeting. It is also advisable that whenever feasible, the directors may also affix their digital signatures during the meeting only, and the same facts should also be captured in the minutes. So directors can give an affirmation that they cannot physically sign now, and they will sign it whenever the opportunity arises or situation and normalcy restored. So they can give an affirmation. On that affirmation only, this company can make it a sign in the financial statements and circulate among the and file with the authorities. The next topic is filing of STK2 application by company to ROC for removing its name from register of companies. See, friends, I have asked a question in various forums. Nobody answered how to wind up a company. Any fast track exit mode is not now, so how to wind up a company? So in the nobody has answered. So to help others, I'm giving this topic in this video. STK2, we have to file a STK2 application to ROC. In this type of company, only the companies which doesn't have any liabilities or assets can file STK2 form application, requesting ROC to remove the name of the company. Only in this case only, as where the companies does not have any assets or liabilities, then only they can go for this kind of binding up. What are the attachments that have to be made along this STK2 application? Affidavit from all the directors individually on 100 rupees stamp paper, duly notarized. Indemnity bond by all the directors on 500 rupees stamp paper, duly notarized. Statement of accounts, nil assets and nil liabilities, certified by a chartered accountant. Copy of the board resolution and a special resolution for winding up, voluntary winding up. Copy of PAN card, Aadhaar and address proof. Copy of MOA and AOA. So these documents are the compulsory attachments with the STK2 form. The third topic is, only the VC meeting could not be recorded due to technical difficulties, but has captured screenshots showing the proof of meeting held and the agendas discussed. Will it suffice? Whether we are 100% compliant? If not, what we have to do? This question has been raised to ICICI, and the agenda include approval of working capital facility, also borrowings from bank. So in the video conferencing board meeting held, they could not record it due to technical snags or technical difficulties or technical clutches. So what will the status of the meeting held like that? So ICICI has issued an answer to this problem. Board meetings held through video conferencing are to be mandatorily recorded, and such recordings are to be maintained till the completion of the audit of the particular financial year. Due to some technical glitches, if the recording could not take place, the chairman and directors may be informed and record the same in the minutes of the next board meeting. This shows the genuineness of the difficulty, and the same satisfies the secretarial auditor as well as the regulators as well as its statutory auditors. So this will be help the companies which cannot able to record the video conferencing meeting due to some technical glitches. Friends, I hope that you will be enjoying this video. If you like this video, I request you to please subscribe my channel. Thanking you once again, R. Vishayagar, practicing company secretary. Thanking you.